Get a computer, dude. Playing games on a Mac is horrific. Thinking of gaming on a Mac? That's cute. Mac for gaming? You must love a challenge. I get these a lot since I've made a series of videos showing my attempts to play games on my MacBook. And yes, I agree with you, Mac is not meant for gaming. But after many hours of testing, I found a way to boost game performance, make more DX11 and DX12 Windows games playable. In this video, I'll share the method to boost game performance on a Mac and what I think is the best way to enjoy games on this machine. This is Tommy, and let's get started. The world was excited when Apple introduced their new OS named Sequoia with many software upgrades. Besides Apple Intelligent, Apple also announced a big update for gaming on MacBook. Most importantly, they revealed the update of Game Porting Toolkit 2. More games will be runnable on macOS, increasing the compatibility of more DX12 Windows games. With this significant effort, Apple Silicon Mac is getting closer to Windows OS in the game compatibility race. To get started with Game Porting Toolkit 2, there are two things you will need: Crossover and macOS Sequoia. In case you didn't know, Crossover is the best Windows emulator to play Windows games on a Mac. To install it, follow the link in the description and click on Try Now to start your 14-day free trial. Once the file is downloaded, double-click the DMG file and finish the installation. For macOS Sequoia, go to General in the System Settings, enable Beta Update, and upgrade to the latest macOS 15 beta version. Now, I assume you have done both of the requirements. Let's get started by clicking on the link in the description, which will direct you to the Apple developer website. Click to download Game Porting Toolkit 2 and fill in your Apple credentials. Now, from the More Downloads page, scroll down until you find the Game Porting Toolkit 2 beta. Click on the DMG file and start the download. When the file is ready, simply double-click on the file and in the pop-up window, double-click on Evaluation Environment for Windows Game to create a virtual disk on your Mac. To get started with Game Porting Toolkit 2, by scrolling down and selecting the second disk, follow the path that's shown on the screen and copy both files inside the external folder. Now, move to the Applications folder and find the Crossover application. Right-click and select Show Package Contents. Now follow the path on the screen and override two files to apply Game Porting Toolkit 2 to Crossover. Make sure you close Crossover before this method to ensure it works successfully. Now let's see the result. I'll test the same games in two different environments so you'll have a better comparison. This Battlefield 1 running on ultra settings with a maximum frame rate from 25 to 30 FPS. Now, you might notice that the game that has Game Porting Toolkit 2 is smoother than before. Apple also added ray tracing and shaders to enhance the game image in this update. So in the game, we're barely seeing any display latency or buffering. Also, Game Porting Toolkit 2 makes games run well with fewer resources than before. We can clearly notice the decrease in GPU and memory utilization. They even perform awesome when running in full HD and medium settings. Super responsive and smooth, with an average of 70 to 90 FPS. For me, it's incredible how the Game Porting Toolkit helps translate and deliver the correct image from Windows games. But at the same time, I realize how stupid it is to keep doing this. Even though the game's performance, story, shaders, or anything else may be great, they're just not meant to be played on an Apple Silicon Mac. Look at how much CPU and memory are used every time we play, not to mention how hot the computer gets. In the long run, this can affect the battery, the main components, the chip, and more. You don't want that to happen to your $3,000 to $4,000 Mac, right? What if next time you try playing some Steam native games for macOS? I believe you'll be blown away by how well these games perform. The reason is simple, they are built directly for macOS. So, the choice is yours. Go ahead and experience gaming on Mac. If you're interested in mobile gaming on Mac, you can check out my video in the description that shows you how to install any mobile app on your Mac. Let me know in the comments what you think about my opinion. Do we have something in common? And this is Tommy. I'll catch you in the next video.